Hey, good morning, everyone. Welcome back to the channel. God bless each and every one of you. Hey, in this video, I'm going to show you a little old project that I'm doing right here. My sister messaged me yesterday and said, "Hey, Mike, I found some more rusty tools. She's gave me several, little piles of rusty tools that she didn't want, and that belonged, I guess, to her and her husband. She said, "I got some. You want them?" And I said, "Oh yeah, I want them." So I immediately put on my warm clothes, go up to her house, and pick up some tools that she had there. And in that box of tools, there was a hammerhead. In this video, I'm going to show you how I'm going to put this handle in this hammerhead, and we'll tell you about the hammerhead. It is really, when I looked it up, it comes from Punch Lock Tools from Chicago, Illinois. So if you go online now, there's a place on there called Worth Point. And it just so happens that this is an 1850s blacksmith's hammer from Chicago, Illinois. So I'm of course, have a little blacksmith shop and like to do that kind of stuff. So I'm going to put this hammer handle into this, show you some more of the stuff that she gave me, and talk to you about it. All right, now I was going to turn a handle down for that little hammer right there, but I didn't have a really good piece of seasoned hickory, so I just went and bought a handle this morning at the Farm Bureau. And they cost about $8. But this hammer in good condition is worth about $100 right here. And that's one of the things that she gave me in the box. Now, of course, railroad spike. And I know you people have seen these in the hardware store. These are, I thought it was a carpenter's, some type of a roofing hammer, and you could use it for anything you wanted to. But did you know these were made to open crates? I looked these up as well. These are the Swordfish brand, and were made to open up shipping crates when they come in on the docks, okay? And of course, an old hoe, an old China-made hatchet head, carpenter's hammer. Check this out. Somebody really wanted to keep the handle in that hammer, didn't he? Nice. An old grate shaker for a cold stove. And of course, an old garden hoe. Anyway, we're going to be talking about this hammerhead right here. Also, hey, check out this block of steel right here I found on the interstate here a few weeks ago. I was out on the interstate there looking for a deer that somebody had shot, and it got away from them, and they asked me to go look for it. I didn't find the deer, but I did find this piece of iron right here that I ended up going back and picking up and carrying out of about a quarter of a mile off of the interstate in a metal bucket. This piece of steel right here, I don't know what it was made for. Evidently, there was a truck wreck there. This got left behind. This thing weighs 60 pounds, a chunk of just soft iron. All right, you all, hope you all can read that on there. Punch Lock Chicago. Now, one of the things that you'll notice is that this is embossed, but check out the lettering. And this is one of the keys to finding old tools, you all. See how the lettering is raised on this? And not, indented in like you would do if you used a stamp. These were mass produced by casting. These are soft iron hammers mass produced by the casting process. They cast the head. And I don't know if the hole is drilled in it later or the hole is cast, but I know that the head is cast and is made out of soft iron. One of the ways that you can tell that is back in the old days, hammerheads were made from soft iron, of course, and then a piece of steel was forge welded to the face of the hammerhead. And all the examples, most of the examples you see on the internet of this particular blacksmith and hammer, these things are mushroomed. And you can see this one saw very little use. I'm pretty sure that these were mass-produced for the horseshoeing industry. And, anybody could use one of them, but I think that's what they were used for. So let's put a handle in. It's looking really good. I think I like it. What I'm going to do is I'm going to shorten the handle to 12 inches, you all.
Just took a little bit of rust off around the edges of it and rounded off the face of the hammer there, you all. Check that out. I really like that right there.
All right, you all, there it is. Punch lock hammer made Chicago, Illinois, 1850s. Wouldn't be surprised if it wasn't used during the Civil War to keep horses shoed and other things repaired during military excursions. Don't know that for sure, but you just never know. I like old tools. I like to get them. I like to get them and put them back in use because this is over 100 years old now, and I can still use it. So I'll put it out there in my workshop and have it there for a chasing hammer or a rounding hammer to do really light work with. You wouldn't want to be hammering hard iron. You can see why they're mushroomed on the internet there is because somebody's used it to, you know, just drive big old pieces of spikes and stuff like that into something, and that will mushroom your hammer and ruin your hammer. Anyway, you all have a, if I don't catch you before Christmas time, and I hope I'm going to, I'm going to do three lives before Christmas. So until then, God bless you all. Thank you all for watching.